Hello students, now welcome to the session of quantity survey and estimation and valuation. In today's session we are going to see different types of estimates. Now basically there are two types of estimates. First one is your approximate estimation and second one is your detailed estimation. Okay, now in today's lecture we are going to see the approximate estimation and justly brief about the detailed estimate, right? Now we'll see approximate estimation. Now approximate estimation is also called as a primary estimate or preliminary estimate. Okay, approximate estimation is also called as a primary estimate or preliminary estimate. Now primary estimate or preliminary estimate or approximate estimate is required for study of various aspect of work of project and its administrative approval. Why it is necessary? It is necessary to understand or to study the various aspect of a work project, and also it is necessary for administrative approval. Okay, now it can decide in case of commercial project whether the net income earned justifies the amount invested or not. By using approximate estimation, you can judge whatever amount you are invested in that project, that amount and the net income from that project is justified or not, that you will get from approximate estimation. Okay, the approximate estimation is prepared from the practical knowledge and the cost of a similar type of work. Okay, the estimate is accompanied by the report duly explaining the necessity and utility of project and with the site or layout plan. Okay, a percentage of 3 to 5%, a percentage of 3 to 5% is allowed for a contingencies. Okay, for a contingency we have to allow 3 to 5% of a cost. Okay, now these are the different methods of approximate estimation. Now what are these methods? First one is your plinth area method, second one is your cubic content method. Plinth area method is also called as a square meter method. Okay, then cubic content method or cubic rate method, you can call it as a cubic rate method also. Then third one is your service unit method. Okay, also you can call it as a units based method, also you can call this it as a unit rate method. Okay, now fourth type is your typical bay method, you can also call it as a bay method. Okay, now fifth is your cost comparison method, and last one is your approximate quantity method. Okay, so there are total 6 methods of approximate estimation. First one is your plinth area, second one is your cubic content, third one is your service unit, then typical bay method, then cost comparison method, and last one is your approximate quantity method. Okay, now we will see one by one. Now first one is your plinth area method. Okay, now the cost of a construction is determined by multiplying the plinth area into the plinth area rate. How will you calculate the cost of construction or cost of a project? By multiplying the plinth area into plinth area rate, then we will get the cost of your building. The area is obtained by multiplying length and breadth. Okay, how will you calculate the area? Length into breadth, we will get the area, that is plinth area. That is, we have to take the length and breadth of a outside dimension of building. Okay, we have to take the dimensions outer of the building, right? Next, in fixing the plinth area rate, careful observation as well as necessary inquiries are made in respect of a quality and quantity, aspect of materials and labors, then type of foundation, then what is the height of building, that you should know, then roof, then woodwork in your building, then fixtures, then number of stories, etc. All that part you have to know and you have to observe necessary. Okay, observation is necessary for that. Now in plinth area method, okay, story of building is very necessary. Then according to the IS 3861/1966, they have given some provision for plinth area calculations, means which area you have to consider and which area you have to not consider. Okay, so they have given some guidelines, so we'll see that guidelines. Now first one is your area which are to include, means which area you have to include in plinth area. Okay, now first one is your area of wall at a floor level. You have to consider all wall area in your plinth area at all floor levels. Okay, now second one is your internal shafts of a sanitary installation not exceeding 2 square meter. Then lift, air conditions, ducts, etc. So here what you have to include, you have to include in plinth area that shafts of a sanitary installation. For sanitary installation we will provide shafts in your building, that shafts you have to consider in a plinth area. Okay, but that area of that shaft shall not be exceed 2 square meter. Okay, if it is within 2 square meter then you have to consider that shaft. And shaft, we are providing shaft for which purpose? Lift purpose. Okay, then air conditioning purpose. Okay, we will provide the duct for air conditioning, so that shaft you have to consider in your plinth area. Okay, now third one is your area of barsati at terrace level. Now what is meant by barsati, I will tell you. Barsati means any covered space open on a one side constructed on a one side constructed on a terrace roof. Okay, barsati means any covered space open on a one side constructed on a terrace roof which is used as a shelter during rainy season, which is used as a shelter during rainy season. Means what? On a terrace you will provide terrace roof. Okay, and that terrace roof, there is condition that the terrace roof should be open from only one face and closed from 3 faces. Okay, then and then only you can consider that area of barsati in your plinth area. So this is the area of barsati. Then next one is your porches of non cantilever type. Okay, if you are provided the porches of a non cantilever type, then that porches you have to consider in your plinth area. So this you have to include in your plinth area. And which area you have to not include in your plinth area, then we will see about that. Okay, area of loft. Okay, area of loft you don't have to consider in your plinth area. Then enclosed balconies. Unenclosed balcony means what? Open balconies, right? That open balconies you have to not consider in your plinth area. Then architectural bands or cornices, etc. Okay, for a elevation perspective or for a elegance perspective, you will provide some architectural bands, then cornices in your building. Okay, that you have to not consider in your plinth area. Next one is your domes, towers projecting above the terrace level. Again, for a architectural point of view or elevation point of view, you will provide some domes, then towers, then some projections above the terrace level that you have to not consider. And last one is your box doors and vertical sunbreakers. Okay, for a sunbreakers or block box windows, you will provide protect from sun and wind that you have to not consider in your plinth area. So you will get which area is to be considered and which area is to be not considered in calculating the plinth area. Okay, in simple calculation, the area of your plinth, okay, into the plinth area rate, you will get the approximate estimation of your building. Okay, now plinth area rate, how will you calculate the plinth area rate? Now we will calculate the plinth area rate from the nearby locations or in that similar locality, we'll consider the same type of building and we'll consider the cost required to construct that building, okay, and that cost of that building divided by the plinth area of that building, we'll get the approximate rate of that building. Clear? Suppose in your locality, suppose you are constructing one bungalow in a Ratnagiri district, right? In Ratnagiri city, you are constructing one bungalow, and in that locality where you are going to construct your bungalow, in that locality there is one another bungalow, right? And similar type of bungalow you are going to construct in that locality. Then what you have to do, that existing bungalow, the cost required about that existing bungalow, that you will get to know, okay? And that cost divided by the plinth area of that building, you will get the amount required for a per square meter for that building in that locality, and that amount into your plinth area for your building, that will give you approximate cost of your building. Clear? So this is the simple method of calculating the approximate cost. Now next one is your cubic content method. Okay. Now this method is generally used for a multi-storied buildings. It is more accurate than the plinth area method, okay, and also by service method. All the approximate methods, estimate methods, the cubical content method is more accurate than other methods. Clear? It is more accurate from other methods. Then the cost of a structure is calculated approximately as a total cubic content. Means what? You have to calculate the volume of your building, okay, and you have to multiply volume of your building into the local cubic rate, okay, and local cubic rate is also calculated from your nearby locality buildings, okay, just like you calculated in plinth area, okay. In plinth area you have calculated rate per square meter, and in cubic content we have to calculate the rate per unit volume, okay. See here, rate per unit volume, right, and this rate you have to calculate same like from a plinth area rate. Means you have to consider one building from that locality and you have to calculate first volume of that building and cost of that building divided by volume of that building, you will get the rate per unit volume of that building, and that rate into the volume of your building, you will get the cost of building, okay. So this is the cubic content method. So the volume of building is obtained by length, then into breadth, into depth of depth or height of building, okay. So length into breadth into depth, all the dimensions you have to take on outside of building, okay. The length and breadth are measured out of the walls, excluding the plinth offset, okay. Now and the height of building, there are different types of measuring the height of building, okay. Means how will you measure the height of building? First method is to measure the height of building from bottom level, may be considered from a ground level or from a top of a foundation. Okay, how will you measure the height of building? See, to measure the height of building, the bottom level may be considered from a ground level, means bottom level you have to consider from a ground level, or from the top of foundation, or from half depth of the foundation, or up to the plinth level, or up to 15 centimeter below the finished surface or a ground level, okay. There are different methods of calculating height. You have to take height up to the top of building, okay, that is fixed, but from where you have to start the measuring the height of building? First option, you have to take from ground to your top of building, okay. Otherwise you have to take from top of your foundation level to the top of your building. This is your second method of measuring the height. The third method is you have to measure from half of your foundation deck to the top of building. This is third option. Fourth option you have to take is from the 15 centimeter from a finished surface of a ground to the top of building. Okay, so these are the different methods of measuring height, but you have to adopt only one method. And we have to adopt which method? We have to adopt the 15 centimeter height below the finished surface, that is from ground level to the top of building. Okay, म्हणजे आपल्याला बिल्डिंगची हाईट कशी मेजर करायची, ग्राउंड लेवल पासून 15 सेंटीमीटर आपल्याला खाली घ्यायचं आहे, तिथून आपल्याला टॉप ऑफ बिल्डिंग. ओके, सो वी आर मेजरिंग द हाईट इन दिस मेथड. ओके, राइट. द कॉस्ट ऑफ ए स्ट्रिंग कोर्स देन कॉर्नाइसेस देन कॉर्बिलिंग एक्सेट्रा इज निग्लेक्टेड. ओके, इन क्यूबिक कंटेंट मेथड कॉस्ट ऑफ ए स्ट्रिंग्स string cores then cornices then corbelling etc is neglected. And the how will you calculate the cost of building? Cost of building is equal to volume of building into rate per unit volume. Okay, so this is about the cubic content method. Now next method is your service unit method. Okay, service unit method or unit based method or unit rate method. Now in this method all cost of a unit quantity such as a per kilometer for a highway, per meter span of a bridge, then per classroom for a school or building, then per bed for hospital, per liter of water tank, etc. are considered first and the estimation is prepared. By multiplying the cost of per corresponding unit by the number of units in a structure. Okay, I will explain it again. How do you calculate the cost of any building or any project in service unit method? If your project is like a per unit basis, means suppose you have to construct a school, right? And in your school you have to provide 10 classroom. So how will you calculate the cost of your school? Cost required for one classroom into how many classrooms are there? 10 classrooms. Okay, so one classroom cost into 10 classrooms, that then you will get the cost of your school. Like that, for a road, cost required for a 1 kilometer. Okay, so you have to prepare a road for a 10 kilometer. So how much cost you will approximately cost required for a 10 kilometer road? Cost of 1 kilometer road into 10 kilometer. Okay, such that for a hospital, cost required for a one bed, suppose you have to construct one classroom. Okay, cost required for a classroom, so you have to first calculate the cost required in class. Suppose there are 60 benches. Okay, so cost required for one bench into 60 benches, then you will get the cost of one classroom. Like that, you have to calculate the approximate estimation for a building or a project. So suppose you have to calculate the approximate estimation for a water tank, means cost required for a 1 liter of water and capacity of your water tank. Suppose 1000 liter of water tank capacity is there, then cost required for 1 liter of water into 1000 liter, you will get the approximate cost of 1000 liter of water tank. Okay, so this is the service unit method. So service unit method can be prepared quickly, but it requires records of a unit current rates for a similar design structure having the same specifications at that locality. Okay, government works are executed through different engineering departments. Each department is entrusted and undertake particular category of work, and it is used to maintain unit cost of those works. Mainly we'll consider the considerations are made in preparation of an estimate by service unit method. Okay, now which considerations we have to take in variation of price level, then change in specification and location of site, then number of units provided in the structure, okay, then what is the soil condition, all these parameters you have to study for a before you are taking the service unit method into account. Okay, so this is about the service unit method. Now next method is your typical Bay method or a Bay method. Now what is meant by Bay method? In this method, approximate estimation cost is calculated as number of bays in a proposed structure into the cost of one such a bay. Okay, I will repeat it again. Approximate estimation is calculated as number of a bays in a proposed structure into cost of a one bay. Okay, now what is meant by bay? We will see bay are the compartments or a similar portion of a structure when the area of a structure consists of a similar cabins or a parts such as a godown, then railway platform, then factory sheds, etc., which have been built up with intermediate columns or with roof trusses on a wall placed at an equal distance, okay, with the same roofing on a top of those supporting member. Then the area may be divided from center to center of a supports. Now each such division may be treated as a bay. Clear? Now I will tell one example. Consider one example of a godown. Okay, suppose there is one godown of a 6 meter wide and 15 meter length. Okay, size of godown is 6 meter wide and 15 meter in length, having galvanized iron sheet roofing on its supporting roof trusses, right? Now brick wall are provided on all sides of that godown, so the godown may be divided into 15 meter the length of godown and 3 meter is a its one compartment. Okay, means how many compartments are there? 15 meter length divided by 3 meter compartment means total 5 compartments or bays are there. Okay, now suppose we have to extend that godown by 6 meter in length, means how many compartment we are going to increase in that godown? 6 meter length means 2 compartment, one compartment is of 3 meter. Okay, so we will add 2 bays in that godown. Okay, so if we know the cost of one bay, how will you know the cost of one bay? You have to know the cost of godown. Okay, suppose the cost of godown is your 1,50,000. Okay, and how many bays are there? 15 meter divided by 3 means 5 bays are there, means the cost of one bay is your 30,000. 1,50,000 divided by 50 means 30,000 is your cost of one bay, and in addition where we will increase the length of your godown by 6 meter, means we will add the 2 bays in that, means how much is the cost of your godown? 15 plus 2 bays means 6 meter. Okay, cost of one bay is your 30,000, means we will add the 60,000 in your cost of godown, means total cost of your godown is 1,50,000 plus 60,000, that is 2,10,000. Okay, so this is the service unit method. Okay, and next one is your this is the typical Bay method, and next one is your cost comparison method. Okay, now in this method, approximate estimate are prepared by prototype of structure, okay, or units consisting several works after comparing with the past records of expenses for a such works. I will tell one example. When prototype staff prototype will take, means what is my prototype? Prototype means similar type of work we have to construct again and again. For example, we'll take the staff quarters for a railway or a any college. Okay, staff quarters. Now, suppose there is one staff quarter for a railway. Okay, now we have to again construct one similar type of staff quarter in another locality. Okay, similar type of, same design, same planning, same staff quarter we have to design in some another locality. Okay, now what we have to do, it is required to estimate approximately then estimate of such a type of prototype works are prepared by comparing the previous cost of present market rate, then normally by the increasing the past cost on a percentage basis. Okay, what we have to do, we have to prepare same sheet of a cost comparison. Suppose there is one existing staff quarter, right? We are going to construct one another staff quarter of the same type, right? We have the estimated cost of a previously done staff quarter, okay, and we have to prepare the same cost comparison statement for a new project by comparing the items and cost of a previously existing structure, right? But you have to check the current market rate. Suppose there is one existing staff quarter, okay, and that staff quarter requires 400 of cement bags, okay, and 400 of cement bags also you will require for your new construction of a staff quarter, okay, but that existing staff quarter required 400 cement bags and you have purchased that 400 cement bags at a rate of 250 rupees at that time, okay, and now in current scenario or in current market rate, the cost of one cement bag is 300 rupees, means there is a 50% of escalation in your charges, okay, so you have to consider that and you have to calculate the new cost of your building, okay, and by preparing the new estimate you have to compare it with previous estimate, okay, so such an estimate can be prepared quickly even during the meetings also, but expert knowledge is necessary for estimating the present cost of construction as compared to the previous recorded cost, okay, so this is the cost comparison method. And the last one is your approximate quantity method, okay. Now in approximate quantity method, multiply the total length of wall of a building in a running meter by the cost of a construction per meter length of a such wall. I will repeat it again. Multiplying the length, total length of a wall of a building in a running meter by a cost of a construction per length of a such wall. Means what? You have to calculate the total length of wall of a building from your plan, then you have to consider different sections of a wall in a building separately. Means for a partition wall there is a different section and for external wall there is a different section, right? A section of wall includes all items of works from foundation level to the roofing level, okay, that section of wall considering with foundation up to the roof. Thus the cost of excavation, then foundation of concrete, then brickwork, then DPC, then proportionate cost for a flooring and woodwork, then reinforced concrete roof, then lime concrete roof, then parapet, then plastering and finishing of wall, etc. per meter length is accounted in that rate, okay. The cost of wall below and above the plinth level should be kept separate. The facilities the spreading of the proportionate cost of work on a superstructure wall. Okay, and what you have to do, you will calculate the total length of wall into the per meter length of wall, rate of per meter length of wall. You have to multiply to the that total length of wall, you will get the cost of your approximate building. Okay, suppose there are two types of wall, one is your partition wall and one is your external wall. Okay, you will take two sections. For a partition wall you will take the different section, and for a external wall you will take the different section. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to calculate the total length of your external wall and total length of your partition wall. Okay, now the rate of your external wall into total length of wall plus length of your partition wall into rate of your partition wall. Okay, and addition of both, you will get the total approximate cost of building. And the rate of your 1 meter length of your rate of 1 meter length of your wall, which includes which items? Your foundation, then brickwork, then DPC, then flooring, then woodwork, okay, then lime concrete, parapet, plaster, finishing, okay, then furniture, if any, that you have to consider in that 1 meter length. Okay, so this is the approximate quantity method. So this is all about the approximate estimation. Now we'll see detail estimate. Okay, now in detail estimate, the preparation of detail estimate consists of working out quantities of various items of work and then determine the cost of each items. And the detail estimate is prepared in two stages. Okay, now the first stage is details of measurements and calculation of quantities. Okay, first you have to calculate the quantities, and in second stage, calculated quantity into the rate of quantity, you will get the estimated cost of your each item, and addition of all that cost, you will get the detail estimate of your building, right? And the second stage is called as a abstract or estimated cost, and first is your details of measurements and calculation of quantities. Okay, and to simplify that, we have one format for a calculation of quantities and for a calculation of cost. For calculation of quantities, we will use the measurement sheet, so you can easily calculate the quantities, and it is in table format, so you can get it easily. Okay, and for calculating the cost, we'll use the abstract sheet, so it is also in table format. Now we'll see both. Now first, details of a measurement and calculation of quantities. The complete work is divided into various items of work. Okay, now that items may be your earthwork item, right? Earthwork means excavation. Then next item is your concrete, then brickwork, RCC, plaster, then floor work, then painting work. There are n number of items in your project. Okay, so the details of measurements are taken from drawings and entered in a respective columns of a prescribed performer, and that performer is your measurement sheet. Okay, the quantities are calculated by multiplying the values that are in numbers columns to depth column as shown below. Okay, what you have to do, see, this is the measurement sheet. See here, first column is your serial number. Sometimes it is written as an item number or item code here. Okay, then next one is your description of item, then numbers, then length, then breadth in meter, then depth in meter, depth oblique height in meter, then unit, then quantity, and then last one is your explanatory note. Okay, now sometimes here you will get to know the item code or item number. Okay, now you already know about DSR, district schedule, right? Now in DSR there are different items. Okay, now for preparing tender, suppose in DSR there is one item, the item is first class brickwork, okay, in a cement mortar 1:6. So this is your item, and for that item in DSR there is one code. Suppose that code is BC101, okay, and BC101 is code for which item? First class brickwork in cement mortar 1:6, okay, and that code is come here, and the description of that item is come here. Okay, suppose you have to, there are 5 numbers of wall you have to construct of a same length, then number, there is here it comes 5, then length of wall, here it will come, then breadth of wall and height of wall. Okay, all in meter means unit of that wall is your length into breadth into height means meter cube, that is cubic meter, this is your unit, and quantity is number into length into breadth into height means your volume into number, you will get the total quantity of wall. You have to write here an explanatory note. In explanatory note you have to write the brickwork. Okay, about brickwork means brickwork in which area of your building. Okay, brickwork for your living room or your kitchen or your dining room, that explanatory note or remark you have to write here. Okay, similarly you will write different items, description of different items, numbers, length, and you will get the quantity of each item. Okay, so this is the measurement sheet. And next one is your abstract or estimated cost. The cost of each item of work is worked out from the quantities that already computed. Okay, and that computed quantities we will get from measurement sheet. In detailed measurements from a workable rate, but the total cost is worked out in a prescribed form is known as an abstract sheet. Okay, now after calculating the abstract sheet, we have to provide 4% of estimated cost is allowed for a supervision, then contingency and unforeseen items. Okay, that we have to add extra after calculating the total cost. See here what we will do in abstract sheet. Item number, okay, or item code, which item, suppose brickwork, I have told the item brickwork, okay, and serial number of that brickwork item is suppose 3, right, or code of that item is BC101, we'll write here item number BC101, description is same, okay, you'll get the description of that item here. Now quantity, calculated quantity in measurement sheet, we have to straight away take here quantity, suppose 100 cubic meter, we'll take 100 cubic meter quantity for that item here, then unit is of that quantity is cubic meter, CM, right, then rate of that item is suppose 1000 rupees per cubic meter, right, so you have to write the here rate 1000, then per unit, the rate is per cubic meter, 1000 rupees per cubic meter, so you have to write per cubic meter. Okay, this is your unit. So quantity into rate, you will get the amount for that item. Okay, so in your building, suppose there are 10 items, we will calculate the amount for that 10 items, and we will finally add that all amount, and you will get the grand total. Okay, and in that grand total, you have to add 4% extra charges for a contingency, then supervision charges. Okay, and you will get the final amount, that is your detail estimated amount for your building. Okay, now you have to see the factors. Now before looking for the factors, I will tell one thing about the detail estimate. Now in detail estimate, we have to know the which documents you will require for a detailed estimation. Okay, now first one is your project report, right? Then specification of each items, means how will you going to construct that any item, suppose for example brickwork or a concrete. The specification of brickwork means which type of brick you are going to use, which labors you are going to use, if any machinery you are going to use, then that machinery. Okay, all the specifications for that item is required. Then very important is your drawing, and in drawing what you will require, your working drawings, then plan, elevation, different sections of your drawings, all that you will require. Then design charts and calculations you will require for your detailed estimation. And last one, your SSR, standard schedule rate, or DSR, okay, which you are provided for that your work that you will require. And now you see factors to be considered while preparing the detailed estimation. Now the first factor is your quantity and transportation of a material. Now for a bigger project, requirement of material is more, okay, such as a bulk volume material will be purchased and transported at a definitely cheaper rate. Okay, so the transportation and quantity of material is required, means you will get to know the transportation cost also, and quantity of material you have to order, right? And next one is your location of site. The site of work is selected such that it should be reduced damage or transit during loading, unloading and stocking of material. You have to select the site such that while loading or unloading the material or transporting the material, the damages should be minimum for that. And next one is your local labor charges. Okay, the skill, then suitability and wages of local labels are always considered while preparing the detailed estimate, right? So these are factors while considering the detailed estimation. And the last one is your fixing of rate per unit of item. Now first one is your quantity of material and cost. The requirement of materials are taken strictly in accordance with standard data book, that is we called as a SDB, standard data book. The cost of this includes first cost, okay, then freight, then insurance and transportation charges. Okay, now next one is your cost of labor. Exact number of labors required for unit of work and multiplied the wages per day to get the labor from unit item work, right? And the next one is your cost of equipment, that is cost required for tools and plants. Some works need special type of equipments, tools and plants. In such cases, 1 to 2% of estimated cost is provided. Okay, and last one is your overhead charges. To meet expenses of office rent, then depreciation of equipments, then salaries of staff, then postages, then light, okay, then for that amount of 4% of estimated cost is allocated. So you have to consider this also. With this, I will stop here. Thank you.